In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, thank you, Heavenly Father. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, you are unchangeable God. Unchangeable God. You are unchangeable God. Unchangeable God. Unchangeable God. You are unchangeable God. Unchangeable God. Jesus, the unchangeable God. Have short time so that we can go deeper into God's word. God will bless you. I hope we are all with our Bible. Let me see your Bible. Raise up your Bible. Raise up your Bible. And Worldwide Church, I hope we are also with our Bible. The Bible. I don't have any other book apart from the Bible. Praise God. I pray God will help us in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the most important book in the whole wide world. And then, the more you study it, the more you read it, your life will be renewed in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We're going to go into something that is going to help us. It's not just all about because of marriage, because in this month, I'll be looking at different series that I have not touched. I want to ensure that as we draw closer to the end of the year, I must have made justice to the totality of God's word. Praise God. So look at marriage series. We've looked at more sanctification, salvation, you know, and then as time goes on, we will look at other elements that you must have that will build you and that will strengthen you even as we travel to heaven in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And so we'll be looking at, you know, the will of God in marriage. Now, this is not just about marriage, as I said. You can use this principle in God's word for every other thing in your life. Many times we are struggling to understand what does God want me to do. But I pray that the Holy Spirit will open our eyes and give us deeper understanding in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So let's look at Romans chapter. Most of these scriptures are not really in the Bible study outline, like I said, because of the way it was prepared. But let's check up Romans chapter 12. Romans chapter 12. This is a very strong scripture to really understand, you know, God's perfect plan and will for your life. It could be in different area and in businesses. First and foremost, something comes first. Look at Romans chapter 12. We'll look at 1 and 2. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. Look at that. It says here, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies, a living sacrifice. It's good you underline that place, a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. First and foremost, the first point we'll be talking about here is maturity. Praise God. Spiritual maturity. You cannot discern rightly. You cannot understand God's plan. There are many things you cannot understand except there is a level of spiritual maturity. There are many things God cannot reveal to me right now because he sees that my knowledge has not grown deeper. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. There is somebody that God gave an experience some times back, and God took the person to heaven, and God said, do you know why I could not show you this while you were younger? I had always wanted to take you to heaven. But because your knowledge was too small,
he wouldn't have been able to grasp whatever God would have revealed to him at that moment. So it says here that presenting your body as what? A living sacrifice, only acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Praise God. So first and foremost, as you begin to grow in grace, as I begin to grow in grace, I will begin to give myself as a living sacrifice. Something you give as a living sacrifice is living, it's not dead. It's not like in those days, you have to kill a dog, you have to kill a bull, and you have to kill a goat. Praise God. And when you kill it, it is dead, and you sacrifice it unto God. No, not so now. Now you are alive, but you are giving yourself up to the Lord. You are alive, you are giving your body to be burnt for God. You are alive, you are staying even in the place of prayer, fasting. You are making sacrifices, genuine sacrifices. Sacrifices that are not spotless. Sacrifices that are not filled with blemishes. Sacrifices that are from a pure heart. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. In my life, one of the things that the Holy Spirit is working on is my motive for doing what I do. Every time Chelo said your motive was wrong. Chelo said your motive was wrong. Chelo said sometimes God, is this how it continues? You know, praise God. Because as you begin to grow, God now begins to watch your inward life. Praise God. Why am I telling you this thing? It will help us to understand God's perfect will and plan in marriage. Because God will not reveal some certain things unto you until He sees that you are matured, you are grown. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. Have you seen a king that dies? Before he coronates somebody as his heir to the throne, he has to see that my son has the capability, my son has the capacity to rule this kingdom. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. Even by the grace of God as I am here, even by the grace of God, before we will leave this earth, we will ensure that great revival, souls have been prepared for heaven. We will not hand over the work of God to people that do not have it at heart. We will not hand over the work of God to people that are not spiritually matured. That's why Paul told Timothy, give this work to those you know that will be able to carry it on. Praise God. Now, what is the connection between this and God's will in marriage? Spiritual maturity. Is this one the will of God? Is that one the will of God? Is this what I should do? How many years are you going to spend trying to understand, is this like this? Is this like this? How many years are you living on this earth? Praise God. You see, you need precision. You need to be concise. You need to understand, you need to be direct, you need to have a sharp eyes, you need to have understanding so that you'll be able to do what God desires that you should do. I see some person, they say, it is this one, it is that one, it is this one. They are just confused. Praise God. But that is why spiritual maturity comes here. Let's go to verse 2. We've not finished with that. It says, and be not conformed to this world. One of the things I tell people, you are not ripe for prosperity. God does not need to bless you. God does not even need to give you a life partner if you are not spiritually matured. You will use it anyhow. You don't need money. What? You don't need money. If you are not spiritually matured, if you are not sound in the things of the Spirit, you don't need all these things. All these things will take you away from the kingdom of God. Praise God. You see, that's why God has to build you. Some of the things that you are asking God, give me this thing, give me this thing, give me this thing. I can't remember when last I prayed for money. But by the grace of God, God has given me my needs. Praise God. I can't remember when. You know why? Because I understand that if a man who is just pleasing the Lord, there are many things God will be doing in your life. So first and foremost, your mind must be transformed. You must not be thinking like the people of the world. Carnality. You must not be saying, let me do it like this. You see, yeah, there's nothing like, let me date. Let me taste. Let me understand. Let's test how she is. Let's test how he is. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. You must understand that, what is the perfect will of God? What does God want me to do? And then listen to me. If you are his son, if you are mature, God will speak to you. Praise God. God will speak to you. I can't remember when last I go to God and say, God, speak to me on this concerning issue. Even though it might take time, it will not be too long. He will speak. Because he sees that you already have understanding. You are right to hear his voice at that moment. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. So, your mind must be renewed from the nonsense, the filthiness, all those things we have learned in the world. We unlearn it. When we come into the kingdom, we live like the kingdom. When we come into the kingdom, that's why I tell people, when people call me from different parts of the world, they say, sir, I need this thing. You know what I tell them? Sanctification. Sanctification. And they are surprised. Why is he saying sanctification? Why is he saying holiness? Why just pray for me and I will get this particular thing I want? But I know in my spirit, man, I will pray and that prayer will be answered. But there is a level of maturity that person needs to understand. Is this the area of business I should go to? Is this the person I should choose? Is this what I should do? Is this that I should do? Is this that I should do? When you begin to grow, I'm telling you, your mind will be open to all things. That's why the Bible says that the anointing that you have received will teach you all things. The anointing, what's that? The power of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit will begin to guide you. He will teach you all things. Praise God. So when I read the will of God in every area, will of God in every area, is in this particular area I should start my business? Is in this particular area? I always tell people that even whatsoever I want to do, even if I want to do a business, that business will surely move. Because I have understood that once I know what is the will of God, what is the will of God? The will of God is perfect. And the will of God brings peace into your heart. I pray God will help us that we do not conform to the standard of this world. We do not say, let's do it like this. We have protocols. You follow the right path. You don't use the back door. And let me give that. When you are trying to use the back door, maybe in your marriage, or you want to bypass marriage committee, and you want to do like this, and you want to do like that, when you are trying to, it shows that something is wrong somewhere. Because as you are growing in grace, you will learn to be obedient. As you are growing in grace, you will learn to follow the path that God has made for us. And look at what he says here. Look at what he says there in verse 2. Look at what he says there. And he says that he may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. And perfect will of God. I pray that God will help us in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Let's look at Galatians chapter 4. Let's look at Galatians chapter 4 and let's see what it has for us there. Because we are talking of spiritual maturity here. Spiritual maturity so that you can understand the will of God in marriage in every area of your life. And that is why you need to grow. That is why you must give preference to God's word. That is why you must hold on to God's word. I can't remember a day that will pass and I don't have to read the word of God. I'm not reading the word of God because I want to preach a sermon. I'm reading the word of God. I'm not the person of the school of God that says, finish Genesis to Revelation, finish it four times, finish it five times. I try to do some of those things. But I'm reading because I want to get revelation. I want to grow. Praise the Lord. You will grow in the name of Jesus. I say you will grow in the name of Jesus. You will grow in the name of the Lord Jesus. Listen to me. What we call spiritual growth, it has to do with how well you follow the Lord. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. You might even be 1 year in the kingdom. And then you can even be more mature than pastor. Praise God. But it is how well you follow the Lord. It is how well you give preference to that particular thing. God will do it in our life so that we don't make mistakes. You know what I'm saying? This thing, the counselings that I do sometimes, you know, it surprises me. This problem, that problem, this problem, marriage, this problem, that problem, this problem. I heard somebody told me, sir, I want to go to hell. I said, go to hell? I said, do you know what hell is? Do you want me to explain them? I said, sir, please, I want to go to hell. I said, it's not you. I knew that it was not her speaking. It's the devil. Though, because this person has been frustrated. Say, sir, it is better. If it is that I must do this and I will go to hell, let it be so. I said, another problem they hear. The only thing here lies to help this person to understand how to grow in the way of the kingdom. So that you don't be thinking like that. If we are mature, we will not be making mistakes. And while mature, you will have a wonderful marital life here on the earth. Praise God. If we are mature, you will live like Jesus even in your home. And then you will be able to choose rightly well. I'm not saying that all will be perfect. Praise God. But I tell you that I lied to you. But see, listen to me. When you are spiritually mature, you will understand how to deal with some certain issues. Praise God. What's the reason for divorce? What's the reason why this person must divorce this person? And that person must divorce this other person. Unforgiveness. If this person decides to forgive this person, where's the divorce? How are we going to have plenty of divorce? Are you seeing? Well, maybe naturally speaking, it was not even God's will. Because what God had joined together, no man can really put asunder in the real sense. Praise God. If that was the perfect plan and the perfect will of God, you know there are some certain things that might not happen there. I pray that God will give us exceeding grace in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. What is the will of God and what is the plan of God? God will help us in the name of Jesus. Galatians 4 verse 19, look at that. It says, my little children, Galatians 4 verse 19, my little children of whom I travail in birth again until Christ be formed in you, whom I travail until Christ be formed in you, until you begin to grow, until Christ be formed in you. You know, that's the spirit of the apostle. Until Christ be formed. Why is he saying until Christ be formed? So that they can have understanding on fulfilling God's plan. Praise God. So that they can have understanding on doing God's will. Praise God. So that they can have understanding on not making wrong choices, on not taking wrong steps, on doing what is right before the sight of God. God will help us in the name of the Lord Jesus. Our marriages will not lack fire. Our marriages will be blessed. Our marriages, the fire and the spirit and the living God will give us exceeding grace in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. We will not miss it. We will get it right. And at the end of time, we will get to heaven in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Because when you get it wrong, when you don't get it right, I'm telling you, it might be hard to get to this heaven. Praise God. Well, you know, it's been like, you know, some of us now, the thing is hot in the body. I want to do this. It's not about now. It's about tomorrow. Praise God. I pray God will help us in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So Paul says, I travail until Christ is being formed, until there is spiritual growth. The second point we have here is your calling and your vision. Praise God. Your calling and your vision. Your calling and your vision. Praise God. Your calling and your vision. So when you are thinking of God's plan, when you are thinking of God's will for your life in every area, it could even be maybe business in every area, you must ask yourself, is this thing in line with my calling? Is this thing in line with the vision of God for my life? Are you just doing it for doing sake? Or is this thing in line? Would this thing help you to serve God? Would this thing help you to love God? Would this help you so that you can be able to go out and preach the gospel? Many times there are people, the minute they just get married, instead of their fire to increase, is when the fire dies. And you be asking yourself, is marriage now a curse? Is when the fire dies, is when the zeal of the Lord is being pulled out, is when, instead of when they should fire, you are now two, you are no more one. Instead of greater grace should begin to come upon their life, you begin to realize that they begin to experience problems. Praise God. You begin to, you know why? There is no alignment with the calling and their own is, oh, this person is just fine, this person is this, this person is that, but they have not asked of the Lord. Is this person going the same direction with me? It could be in the area of business. You know, you should not sell things that are ungodly. You should not sell things that will promote ungodliness or that will take people to the fire of hell. You must ask yourself, this particular thing, is it in line with God's calling and vision for my life. Praise God. So that you don't make mistakes. We are not going to make mistakes in the name of the Lord Jesus. Because there are some mistakes that you make. I don't know. It's sometimes irreversible. And that's why when it comes to marriage, it's irreversible. You can't say like, okay, I'm married now. Let me go and marry again. No. Going to heaven is shaking already. You sure? Satan has used this bait now to keep some people, to pin some people down. Going to heaven is already shaking. You can't tell me if you divorce, you know, somebody maybe you were legally, rightfully married to, married in the right way and everything, and then you divorce and then you are now talking on going to heaven. Even if you use scriptures, you know, to encourage yourself and say all is well, all is not well. Because when you die, you will answer to the living God. Praise God. When you die, you will answer to the Lord your God. When you die, you will appear before Him. And God will begin to ask you questions. May we not be found wanting on the last day in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I say, may we not be found wanting on the last day in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. May we not be found wanting on the last day in the name of the Lord. Help us to understand this. You know, is this thing, do we have the same vision? Or is there diversity of vision? Praise God. When there is diversity of vision, there will be division. When people don't understand the vision that God has given to us in this church, there will always be division. There will always be rebellion. Because they don't understand the vision. You know? So when there is diversity of vision, the man is going this way, the woman is going this way. You want to pray, you want to do fasting. The person does not understand fasting and prayer. The person is like, no, we don't need to fast and pray. Fasting is too much. And when you say, let us fast, and then the woman will go and tell the children, I beg you, don't mind daddy, the way daddy is doing this thing. I beg, men are eat more food. You know, this, your daddy are fasting and prayer. He's not this too much. You people should eat. Are you going to kill these children for me or so? Well, because you don't understand that it's not just about, you know, because you don't want the children to do this. It is a vision that the man carries that you have to key into so that the children and the family and everybody will key into it. Because one thing I've realized, you know, when it comes to marriage, the lower spiritual person will always be a tool in the hands of the devil. Praise God. If, let me say, two people are married, one person is on fire, the other one is not on fire. The other one that is not on fire will give problem to the other one that is on fire. Because when the kingdom of darkness, when Satan is looking down from heaven, and Satan is saying, how do I stop this man? He knows that there is only one way to stop this man. Get the person that is close to him to stop him. Praise God. And you see, that is why as you are spiritual, the other person too must be spiritual. So that there won't be problem. That's why God said, do not be unequally yoked with a world unbeliever. You know why? What has fellowship of light has to do with darkness? You know why? Because when the two people don't have the same direction, they don't have the same light, they don't have the same calling, they don't have the same vision, they are not looking the same place. I'm telling you, it will be almost impossible to serve God in that way. It will be a problem to serve God. Because for you, you see that life is a spiritual war. And you might want to pray over some certain things. This person sees it like you are a fanatic. You are a fanatic. Everything is prayer. Everything is demon. Everything is devils. Everything is this. Not knowing that life is spiritual. Not knowing that what? Life is spiritual. This life is spiritual. Nothing just happens for happening sake. Something must make something to happen. Nothing just happened for happening sake. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. So one of the things that we're going to ask ourselves is this. Your calling and vision, you know, alignment according to God's plan. This will help you to make a very right, good decision. Praise the Lord. Will help you to make a very good, right decision. And then the third point we have here is conviction in your heart. Conviction in your heart too has to do with maturity. Because it has to do with hearing God. But this one now is not that. It's not that you had a dream or you saw a vision. There's what you call conviction in the heart. Conviction in the heart is that when you see a particular thing, that the Holy Spirit just gives you an intuition inside of you that this is it. I don't know if, for example, like before we started, you know, the Headquarters Church, I was just, that was, it's not like ending 2017. I was just moving around Maya. I don't even know Maya. I don't think Parafa I know. I was just moving. I was thinking between maybe it's Parafa or Adamo. I don't know anywhere, you know. As I was just walking by this area, I just saw that mission house. Something said, somebody just told me, it is here now. You are the right place. Somebody just told me, I just had the feeling, you know, I just feel the intuition that, yes, you've gotten it right. And that was the final bus stop. I don't know the other person. Stop searching. No. I think this is the right place. My spirit agrees. I just realized, look, I've gotten to the right place. Even though I was praying too. Praise the Lord. Are you seeing what I'm trying to talk about? Now, that has to do with growth process. Because if there is no growth process, your intuition is hearing the voice of God inside of you will not be strong. It will not be strong. And then you will not understand what might be the perfect will and the perfect plan of God. I pray that God will help us in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we will begin to understand whatsoever is His perfect will and His perfect plan. Let's go to Acts chapter 13. Acts chapter 13, verse 2. It says here, as they ministered, Acts chapter 13, verse 2. Okay, it says here that what? It says, as they ministered to the Lord and fasted, the Holy Ghost said, as they ministered to the Lord, minister to the Lord means as they are praying, as they talk to God, as they ministered to the Lord and fasted, the Holy Ghost said what? Separate me, Barnabas and Saul, for the work whereunto I called them. Praise God. And when they fasted and prayed and laid their hands on them, they sent them away. Separate me. Are you seeing? As they ministered unto the Lord, is it that? I don't think that is like maybe one thunder voice spoke from heaven. Separate me, Paul, from here, from Barnabas. No. As a minister, God must have ministered into their heart. You know that still small voice you hear? You are not the one, you know, it is the Lord speaking, and then He's speaking inside of you. And then, one thing about God speaking into your heart is that you are convinced inside of you. You just know that this thing is God. You just know that this is God. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. Today, before waking up, you know the difference between that time you are waking up and you are hearing the voice of God. You know, let me tell you, let me give you a secret. Mark this secret I'm giving you. It's a secret I'm giving you. If you want to hear the voice of God, on any matter, in the morning, that time before you will wake up, you know that time you are already waking up. Your spirit is very active and too sensitive. An angel of the Lord will look you. The spirit of the Lord, because the angel of the Lord is by your side, you will not know. But I tell you, that's what happens every day of your life. You will not know. If the angel of the Lord is not there, your which is your guardian angel, you will not be able to wake up. That is called death. Because a demon must have come to afflict your body in one way or the other. Read the psalmist very well. You will realize a secret about David. David was the man of the midnight hour. David was the man of the morning hour. He really understood it. Your mercies are new every morning. Something that is being renewed. Every morning is an opportunity God gives to every human being. So, the split of time before you will wake up and you listen. Always know that God is about to speak to you. If you are very sensitive and you have been asking God for something, you must know how to train your spirit to hear from the Lord. At that moment, if you are trying to know, should I go to Kaduna or Abuja? Or should I go to Ethiopia? Or should I go to China? At that moment, and you are praying and it is in your heart, the voice of God will speak. Ethiopia.
Hallelujah.
Go to Ethiopia. You will think, is it me that is speaking or this thing? I'm just telling you how it works. It's a secret. The voice of God will speak. It's China. It's China. Very silent. You know they shout. No, no, it's China. It's China. It's Ethiopia. I'm telling you, that's God speaking to you. But you will not, you might not know. That's God speaking to you. This morning before I would wake up, I saw something. I saw something covering my bed. I first thought that I was in the, you know, there are times you think you are in the real life. You know that space between waking up. You think, you don't know that that's it that was happening. You might think that you are talking to your son. You will think that you are talking to your son. Maybe, for example, you will think that, let me say, Stimelina, you think you are talking to your brother. Also, get me a cup of water. You don't know that you are not talking to him in the physical realm. It's a spirit thing. Has that happened to you before? Praise God. Has that happened to you? You think you are talking to somebody in the physical. But all of a sudden, you just woke up and you just realize, that is what you call trance. Praise God. Are you hearing me? That's what you call trance. And what I'm letting you know this is that this will help you to understand a lot of things that you have been crying to God for. A lot of things, or is this God's will for my life? Is this what God wants me to do? This will give you precision. I saw something like that looks like a canopy around me. A brown canopy. Big around my bed. Naturally, I always have a net around me. But I saw a kind of, I was like, is this real life? I mean, or something like that. Then until I now entered into the normal state. That's like a child. I now realized, is there a canopy on top of my head? I now realized that this is the covering of God. This is the protection of God. Just this morning, I just saw this thing. Then I heard a voice in my spirit. That's that thing I'm telling you now. I'm trying to help you understand. This same morning, I heard a voice in my spirit. You know what the voice said to me? The voice said, I know what you are thinking. You think this is a canopy. But I said, this is made with a material you cannot understand. It's made with a metallic material. Then I now realized, I now remember in the service where it says, it's canopy covers me, or it's covering to cover me, or the angel of the Lord. I now realize that this is God's covering upon his children. That's why the devils cannot touch you at midnight hour. That's why they can't kill you. That's why they can't afflict you. When you understand this, you now begin to understand the plan of God and what is the perfect will of God. We would understand in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We will understand all this in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. This will help you not to be deceived. Not to be deceived. Because you might be praying, God, the will of God, the will of God. But if you are not mature, if you cannot hear God's voice, you might hear only because there are many spirits that speak. That is why you must be matured in the word. You must be renewed by the word. There must be growth process in your life in the word. As I begin to grow in the word, I begin to naturally understand what is the will of God. Praise God. In short, as you grow in the word, there are many things you will not struggle in this life about. As you grow in the word, there are many things that will not be like a struggle anymore. As you grow in the word, you know, you won't be asking yourself, should I do this? You just know. You just know. You just know. You just know it's like this. You just know it's this. Wait, if it's taking you years to pray over one thing, how many years do you live here on it? If it takes you 5 years now, 5 years, and then you are praying, you know, as if you are doing a study in the university. 5 years, you are praying for the will of God. 5 years, okay. Then you enter around 5 years, you are praying. Lord, 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 should I have 2, 3 children? Then you spend 3 years again, you are praying like that. Then maybe everything like that you spend. And then, should I do business like this? Or should I be selling this? Or should I not be saying, take another 3 years? If you go like that, how many years are you going to live on it? For example, now you live 90 years, which is good. If you remove all those years now, how many years do you have on earth? Are you understanding? Let me tell you a secret. Though I learned this, there is a reason why God did not allow us to live long, like Abraham, like Adam, Enoch, Methuselah. Do you know the reason? I was listening to something very deep. You know what God said? God said there is no need for you to live as long as these people. When Enoch would be like 200 years old, it's like when you are 20 years old. It takes them almost like, you know, they are the ones that began the earth. So the Lord said, because they are the ones that began the earth, I have to allow them to live long to know a lot of things. For example, now, you, a small child at the age of 5 years, you already even know that if you want to light a candle, you take matches and do it like that. For them to create fire, they might have to do this, do that. They might have to be researching, which can take them another 20 years to realize in order to get fire, you need to put two stones together, heat it like this, fire will come out. I don't know if you understand. Do you have to take 20 years to do that? No, no. For them, you already have the word. For them, they have to learn a lot of things. Because they were the beginners of the human race and the human existence of man, God had to give them plenty life to live. Maybe 900 years. It was good for them. Now, it is not better. If you even spend 90 years, what do you want again? What do you want to learn? What do you want to understand? What do you want to have on this earth? People enter 100 years like punishment to some people. You know, 110 years. There are some people, they don't do it like punishment, because by the time you're old, like, you can't do much. It's just like you are almost useless on there. You can't achieve anything. There is no need leaving you there. 120 years, you are already wrinkled. You cannot even take care of yourself. You cannot bath yourself. You cannot use the toilet. What are you doing? Praise God. So you see, that's why you need to grow. Study this Bible so that you will not be deceived, so that you will not be carried away. You will know what you want. I am a child of God. I am a child of God. You will know what you want. You will know at that moment that this is God's plan and this is God's will for our lives. You will exactly know what you want. The Lord God Almighty will perfect this in our lives in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So, because you will now begin to understand what is the perfect will and the perfect plan of God, I know that it is going to be so in our lives in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We are going to also look at something here also. And then we are going to look at the power of prayer and fasting also, which is praying, fasting, and confirmation. Now, just letting us know how to understand the will of God in marriage. Because you need to pray. You need to fast. No, there are some people, they are prayed. They get the answer. They get the confirmation. They don't need anybody to pray for them or confirm. Or somebody like that. There was somebody like that, you know, in the church, you know. I'm like, I've not even prayed, and then you have already concluded. I've not even confirmed, and then you have already concluded. Well, I do what you want to do now. Praise God. Even before I prayed and done anything, you know, the person already has his desire. When you already have an idol in your heart, God will answer you according to the idol in your heart. When you already have what? An idol in your heart. God will answer you according to the idol. According to that which you have imputed in your heart. You see one thing about God, you can't cheat God. Praise God. You can't be seeking confirmation from God in a particular thing and then you are committing sin. You can't be seeking confirmation of a particular thing and then you are committing sin, you are doing this, and then you want God to speak to you. God will not speak to you. Praise God. You can't be asking God, speak to me here, and then you are doing the wrong thing. You must stay in the word, you must stay in prayer, you must stay in fasting. You must be able to ask of the Lord. You must be able to confirm from the Lord. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. So prayer and fasting, very important. Very important because God will be able to speak to you. Though you need the mercy of God to be able to make the right decision. Because I know that there are people that have fasted. There are people that have fasted and prayed. There are people that have fasted and prayed. And still yet, they are not able to get the perfect plan and the perfect will of God. Praise God. That's why it will lead us to Matthew chapter 17. Matthew chapter 17. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. We are going to make right choices in the name of Jesus. Matthew chapter 17 verse 21. He says that, howbeit, this kind goeth not out but by prayer and fasting. And I always also, I change this scripture in my own way. This kind cometh not to, except by what? Prayer and fasting. As this kind goeth not, this kind too cometh not into your life. Praise God. There are some open doors you will not have. There are some hearing voice of God or hearing the voice of God you will not perceive until you are staying in the place of prayer and fasting. God wants to know that you will genuinely seek Him, and those that genuinely seek Him will find Him. Those that hunger for righteousness, what the Bible says that they shall be filled. So when God sees that you have a desire in your heart to do a particular thing, He will give it to you. Do you know that there is a technique they use in consulting Satan? There is some certain magical things you will do. You just consult the devil, he will appear. If you don't do it like that, you will not be able to consult him. You don't need to learn about those things. But there are things you do. You consult spirit. It's the same thing too. If you also want the hearing voice of God, you want to understand the will of God in marriage, you want to make right decision, you don't want to walk by flesh, you don't want to walk by somebody said, they said, he said, she said, prophet said to me, they prophesied, they said this one to me. You want to live by the word of God. You must pray accurately fast. Don't have an idol in your heart. Don't say, I want it like this. I want it like this, like this. It must be like this. It must look like this. It must, you know, when you are giving God, as if you are giving God, what do you call it? As if God is your visitor, you are telling Him it must be like this. No! You will only receive according to the idol of your heart. You read in Isaiah, or is that Ezekiel? When the prophet comes to him and he already has an idol, is that God will answer you according to the idol that you have imputed in your heart. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. So, by the special grace of God, we must allow God. If I had known the will of God for me in many areas, or I had known maybe very young that I was called, I would have been training myself. I would have even began to study some certain things. I would have just been equipping myself. And before you know it, at the age of 10, at the age of 15, before you know it, I would have started serving the Lord. Praise God. Praise man. You know what I'm telling you this for your children? And I told myself, I will not bring any child onto this earth. Even before I will bring any child on this earth, I must know the will of God for that child. I must know the gift of God. And at a tender age, maybe at the age of one, I will start to harness the gift. If I know that that child is very smart academically, the child has a very powerful memory, or if I know that this child is already born a prophet in the gift giftings of the Spirit of God. If I know that God is calling this child, or maybe in the secular world, to begin to make and put some certain things right, I should be able to now walk towards that, so that he can fulfill and she can fulfill the perfect plan and will of God for his or her life. Praise God. If our parents understood the will of God, I'm telling you the simple truth. There are some certain things you will experience in your life. That is why there are battles your parents did not fight. You fight it. There are things your parents did not make way right. Maybe because of their level of understanding, their knowledge in scriptures, you make things right. Praise God. So that when you are going to give birth, when you are going to have offspring, there will be godly offspring. They will set the earth on fire. They will change the course of this generation. You know, there are some people that they just came to this earth, and it is because of them. If somebody like Martin Luther now, God did not use him, you think we will be free to do what we are doing here? The Catholic Church would have dominated the earth, because they were dominating the earth. Praise God. But a man rose up and said, no, he just must be by faith. I see a man of destiny. I see a man of destiny. It's somebody like, you know, John Wesley. You know Wesley. He did not have a godly mother that was praying for him. Look at today. Maybe true Methodists. There are many people that have entered heaven through that way. They might not be the way they used to be or something like that. I don't know if you understand. You know, you don't need plenty of people. Just one person that understands the will of God can shake the earth. God did not call you just to be on this earth for being saved. God did not call you to occupy space like matter. God called you for a reason. God called you. He has a plan. He has a will. When you don't know your purpose of existence, you will not live a very wonderful life. I'm telling you the simple truth. But when you know, this is God's plan for my life. When I got born again, at the age of, 19, I got born again. Immediately, as God began to speak in me, before you know it, from that time I started preaching. Around 20, I started preaching. 21, I started going for crusade, traveling all around. And I already knew. Sometimes when I was on campus, people were like, this boy is not serious. So not that I was not serious with school, but I was focusing on the one that is eternal. I gave my time to the spiritual. Praise God. Praise Master. Because I knew that this was the perfect will of God. This was the plan of God. I did not begin to waste my time on things. How many years do I have to live here on earth? So that by the grace of God, before I get to a particular age, I would have done this. I would have done this for the kingdom by the grace of God. Listen to me. The speed you are experiencing or you are waiting for in your life has to do with you understanding what is the perfect will of God. Praise God. So that you will not waste your time chasing shadows. You will not waste your time chasing money. You will not waste your time chasing things that you ought not to chase. I pray God will help us in the name of the Lord Jesus. Walk in that direction. If it is in marriage, this brother, this sister, we are going the same direction. You begin to build yourself up in that direction to fulfill the perfect plan of God. God did not create marriage only for procreation. He created marriage so that the two people will fulfill a purpose on the earth. Praise God. Because he knows that two will be able to do greater, mightier, wondrous things. Praise God. So there is a reason why God brought two together. Because he knows that two will change tens of thousands. He knows that two will be able to do greater works and mightier works. There is a reason. So marriage is not just born children, you live together, how are you doing? Go to work, bye-bye, God bless you. You don't understand anything, nothing. That is why many people are tired of the marriage. There is nothing to expect. That's why don't marry a man that doesn't have a vision. I'm not of the school of God that will tell you, because a man does not have money, don't marry him. I don't believe in that. Whether he has money, whether he does not have money, that's no business. But what I'm looking out for is vision. Does he have a vision? Does he know where he's going to? Can he tell you where he's going to in 5 years' time? Can he tell you? When you see what a man is doing now, you will know what he will do in 5 years. You will know what he will become in another 5 years. Just give him 5 years. When you know what a woman is doing now, you can know what will be or by in the years to come. So these are questions that it's not just it's fine, no, it's fine, it's tall, you know, this lady, she's fine, no, she's white, she's black, he has money, I mean, she has money, I mean, all those things are not even the main important thing. The main important thing here is vision, is purpose. Are we going in the same direction? Praise God. Will this person take me to heaven? Or does this person have anger issue? That if I do one small thing, I carry cutlass and cut my head like this. You know, all the domestic violence that you see all around. You know, two people that say they are in love and they don't begin to kill each other. It doesn't make sense. It is as a result of that thing I said in the beginning. Lack of spiritual maturity. Why should you raise your hand and slap a woman? For what reason? For what reason should you raise up your hand and beat a woman? For what reason should you abuse your wife or vice versa? Because I heard that there are also women that beat the husband or husband beat the this. It can happen in different ways. Praise God. For what reason must you do that? But when there is spiritual maturity, when there is spiritual growth, like one I saw a video and then the man shot the woman. Kill the woman. And when he killed the woman, he's still even saying it. Yes, it's good. It's good that I kill you. I say, Jesus. I don't know. I'm scared. Like, you kill somebody, I thought that you should like be reminded. Yes, it's good that I kill you. You know, something like that. I say, Praise God. And these things are always happening. You know, I know it happens in Africa, but it happens in the European world, in the American world. That's why take your time to pray. Don't be in a hurry. There is no first position for the person that married first. Praise God. There is no first. Nobody is giving first position and say, I give you first position because you marry. No. But it is to marry the plan of God. It is to marry the will of God. It is to seek the face of God. It doesn't matter. Somebody might say, we have children together, so let's be like this. Even if you have children together, children does not define that this person must be your husband or your wife. I'm just telling you the simple truth. Children does not define that. You can make mistake, and then you live in sin, and then you give it to one or two children. Does not mean that it must be the will of God. Praise God. That was the result of your sin. That was the fruit of sin. The child is the fruit of your sin. You must bear the consequences. So one thing about sin is that God will forgive you, but it has its consequences too. Praise God. Most of the things that we are suffering many times, they are as a result of sin. God is trying to discipline us. Not because he hates us. He's trying to discipline us. My beloved, God wants us to understand in everything we do, are you in the will of God? Are you in the plan of God? And if you know you are not in the will of God, you are not in the plan of God, you can make things right. It's not too late. Though if you are married, I'm not saying that I'll make things right now by leaving the marriage. No. But you can make things right. You can make things right in other areas. By asking yourself, is it like this? Is this how God wants me to live? Is this where he wants me to stay? And then if you are not yet married, pray. Pray very well. Pray very well. Pray very well. If somebody comes to me and tell me, sir, this I want to marry. Naturally speaking, I can know if this is God's will or if it's not God's will. But on recent, I told myself that I will not be dictating for people when it comes to marry. You marry what you want to marry. Praise God. I'll guide you, I'll pray for you, God will lead you. But you marry. But for me to say, okay, this one is down my marriage, like, I hardly will do it. Except on rare occasions. Praise God. Because marriage too is a choice you make. It is you that is entering. It's a lifetime agreement. Until death do you part. Marriage is basically among two people. Two persons that make agreement. Amos 3:3. Shall two work together except they agree? Two people, and you agree, nobody is putting you under duress, nobody is forcing you, nobody is dissing, you are matured, you are grown, you agree, okay, no problem. And I know that as time goes on, you know, we will know the standard and the orderliness structure to follow this, but this is just understanding the will of God. It's not, oh, I just met this person. The person say he love me. I mean, how, you know, like that. I mean, the person say he like me or he love me, or like, then this is the will of God. No, it doesn't work like that. You must do a search. You must do a foundational work. You must dig the ground and then know so that you don't make mistake. But by nature, you know and you say that you have made mistake. Let me tell you the beautiful thing. Because if you married in ignorance and if you married when you were not born again, I'm about rounding up because of time. If you married when you were not born again, let me tell you something good now. God can bring the best out of your failure. That is the good thing about God. God can bring the best out of nothing. God can bring perfection out of nothing. Are you getting that? So, even if you have made a mistake, let me tell you, God can change that mistake into something better and glorious. That's what I realized about God. So, I don't want you to say, me, I've already passed that area, you know, I cannot turn back the hand of time. Because it's not now, I married as an unbeliever in ignorance, let me just divorce and No. If that was somebody, the Bible says that the unbeliever is sanctified by the believer and the believer by the unbeliever, you know. So what do you do like that? You keep praying, oh God, let my spouse be born again. Let my spouse know God. You keep praying, don't stop praying. God will hear your prayer. But if you're having anger in your heart towards the other spouse, malice in your heart, this in your heart, and then you are praying, that prayer will not be answered. I pray God will help us in the name of the Lord Jesus. Let's bow down our heads. Heavenly Father, King of all glory, we thank you for your word. We're asking for your grace, Father, to make the right choices in our lives. Every human being is an embodiment of the choices that they have made on this earth. Give us the grace. Help us. So that we don't make mistakes. And so that we don't miss heaven. Thank you, Heavenly Father. This we have prayed in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Let me just pray for the offering and tithe. Praise God. Heavenly Father, King of all glory, we give this unto you, Lord. Enlarge our coast, even as we give unto you. Our offerings and our tithes shall not be in vain. O Lord God Almighty, prosper the works of our hands. And O Lord, guide our footsteps, even as we give from our hearts.